Good morning, guys. Welcome to the Shane's End and a brand new video today. So this is the first of the four matches which is going to ultimately determine the season for us, the season for Frank Lampard. So please watch till the end and we're going to talk about this. We're going to talk about how we should line up against a strong, informed team like Sheffield United away from home. It's not going to be easy. So here we go. Let's talk about it. So yes, guys. Now, before I start this video, just as a clear update, there were a couple of people who were telling me about why don't I talk about the transfers related to the Benrahma, Havertz, and any upcoming Chelsea, any defender, world-class defender. So I'll tell you, my channel is based on fact more than on fiction. There's a lot of talk in social media about, you know, this player is joining, or this, there's a bid there. Nothing is concrete. Whatever the reason is behind that, maybe a reason is that we are not yet there, that we need to finish top four. Our team, our ownership is targeting a top four for us to maybe contact any of these players. Maybe a Willian's contract, maybe anything, maybe a contract overall when it comes to Havertz. You know, it's a contract, is a very expensive one. It's almost 100 million. So nothing is concrete. So somebody somewhere writes something and we make a video on that. I know a lot of people do that. And I'm not saying they're wrong, but it just, I based on facts, something needs to be more concrete for me to make a video on that rather than just make a video for the likes of views and everything. So from my point of view, I think nothing is concrete as yet. Unless we finish this season, you're not going to hear anything. So these four matches, starting from today, the first of the four, is going to be interesting. So let's get straight into it. Sheffield United, a very informed team at this moment, about mid-table team, 6th, 7th. They're also trying to get into the top four, but they have an outside chance. Most likely they will not make it. But saying that, it's a very tough team to play against. They are a typical English physical side. And you understand, over the last few years, if you've been following Chelsea for the last few years, you will know sides like these tend to beat us. You know, we have seen it in previous years. Teams which are in the range of 5th to 11th tend to get some kind of result against us, especially when they're playing at their home and we are playing away from home. So this is a very interesting fact to take in mind, and Frank will have to really work hard to get a proper team going here, because if we make any mistake here, we're going to drop points here. Now, we have been lucky, and I mean it when I say the word lucky, when we have beaten the likes of Crystal Palace and Aston Villa. Aston Villa, I can see it was more comfortable. You know, but it's not going to be easy here. We would have easily dropped points to Crystal Palace. We lost to West Ham. And this is a team which is in a much better position than these teams. And these teams, Crystal Palace, West Ham, you know, these are the teams which are at the lower half of the table. And they're trying to avoid relegation. So we struggle with them. So I can understand how it could happen with this team, which is actually not struggling and is playing pretty good football here. Now, after this match, Sheffield United match, we have Norwich, so I'm expecting that to be a one, that we should be winning that. Now, then we have Manchester United in the FA Cup next weekend. That will be very interesting. And after that, Liverpool in the Premier League, we go to Anfield, to the champions' home. That's how it is these days, Liverpool champions. And then the last match is against Wolves at home. So we have to make sure we get these points done before we can talk about those matches. So it's very important for Frank to get the team, correct team that is. And so we'll go straight into that. Now, first and foremost, Kante and Billy Gilmore is out. Billy Gilmore has a long layoff, it seems, 3-4 months. It seems that he was injured in the 20th minute, but he kept on playing till the 80th minute. I'm not sure what happened on that, why he was playing an extra 1 hour when he was already injured. Maybe the medical staff did not know the extent of the injury and let him play, which led him now to be out for 3-4 months. Or what? They didn't want Jorginho to play, whatever. You may let me know in the comment section. So here we go with the team news. Starting with Kepa, very simple. Kepa has to play. I'm sorry about the wind. There could be some noise disturbance, but please bear with me on that. But yeah, Kepa at goal. Christensen and Zuma in the central defense. Don't want to change that, though. I can say Rudiger might come in, as I keep on telling about this, that we are playing so many matches in so short time. You know, every defender and every player can make mistakes. And so even Christensen and Zuma can make mistakes. And then everybody will start jumping around saying, see, these players are making mistakes, so what did Rudiger do wrong? and it's quite a point. So you need to interchange the players. So I will not be surprised if Rudiger comes in today, but most likely will be Zuma and Christensen. And on one side will be Azpilicueta and Reece James, though I prefer Alonso to come in. Again, the same thing. Reece James is a little inexperienced, maybe English. So he might know a little bit about playing against teams like Sheffield United, but I still believe that there is a need of bringing little, fresher legs. So I think Alonso and maybe Azpilicueta on one side, Alonso on the other side might help. But I'm pretty sure Frank is not so keen on bringing players like Alonso. He wants to let them go to different clubs, make that money so that he can buy other players, maybe a defender, maybe a left back like Tagliafico or Chilwell, who knows. So come to the main point, because everybody's talking about this main player, this one player, Jorginho, if he's going to be in the team or not. And what I think about it, most likely he's not. So he's not going to start. We're going to start with Kovacic, who is fit, and most likely Kovacic, Barkley and Mount is going to start. I will prefer Jorginho and Kovacic to start along with Mount. I don't think that's going to happen. Most likely Jorginho is going to come in the last half an hour and try to make sure that we don't concede. He settles the midfield. The midfield looks very erratic, especially last match against Crystal Palace. It looks really off, and it really looked bad until when Jorginho came in. He made it look really smooth. That's what a world-class player does, and that's what Frank has to understand, that he has world-class players on the bench and he needs to play them. Anyways, so I don't think Jorginho will start this match. And so what about the wingers? We know the two best players right now in the last 1 month or so is Willian and Pulisic. They're going to start unless they have injuries. Willian is really playing that well, that we have never seen him play that well, just for that contract, which is great. I mean, you need the players to play their best, and he's doing a great job. No questions on that. Giroud to start as a lone striker, quite natural. Though I'm very happy that Tammy did score a goal, and it's good for his confidence. Maybe we'll see Tammy Abraham sometime in the match, or maybe he starts, but I think it really Giroud will start. It would make sense to start with Tammy when Giroud is also scoring goals and doing well. So that's how it is for me. I believe that it's very much Jorginho is not going to start in this match. As always, it's been that case. I'll be surprised if he does. If it's a change of heart from Frank, could be something Jorginho's agent said. It's a lot like what Ole and Paul Pogba had in Man United earlier this season. A similar thing might have been happening right now. But Pogba looks good right now for Manchester United. If you say he, Bruno Fernandes, and if you look at how Manchester United is playing right now, they're really playing for the Champions League spot. I think Frank has to think about that and bring on these players, the world-class players that we have, so that we can make the maximum effort against teams like these and get those 3 points, which is the ultimate thing for us at this moment. More than anything else, no egos. Keep egos aside at this moment should be the main thing, but there could be more to it. So not going to get into that. It will be a tough match against a tough team. We need those 3 points at this moment. It's the first of the four matches, starting with this one, and we need those points. Destiny is in our hands. It's as simple as that. We win these matches, we go through. There's nothing second point about that. Well, let's see how Frank does this one. All is to say that we have to win it. I leave it at that. You guys, as I always keep on coming to you guys, please let me know in the comment section what you guys think about this team selection of Frank. If you guys think Jorginho is going to play today or not. Everything. And let me know if you want me to make more videos about other players or other things or anything that's upcoming. I will try to make those as and when possible. But from hearing, I love to hear from you guys. So until next time, guys, I sign off. Bye.